Today, we're gonna take you on a quick trip to see how we make UMCs. And we're gonna start with the raw castings out here in the yard.
And we'll finish with a completed machine all packed up and ready to go right out here in our shipping area.
We've got 450,000 square feet of storage out here in what we call the casting yard. And we go through these castings quickly enough on all our machine lines that typically we'll turn over this entire yard in about 30 days. That means that before the end of 2020, this casting right here will probably be sitting on a customer's shop as part of a brand new UMC 750.
Now we machine every casting in-house using a variety of machines. In this case, we're machining UMC 500 bases on this double column five-sided machine. Now these guys have it down to a science, using cycle time and tool life to make a highly efficient operation.
This is the starting point for every UMC. This is what we call the cast assembly area. To begin with, we install linear guides and ball screws on every major assembly. Every assembler out here on the floor, including Kennedy right here, uses an iPad for work instructions and specifications. They even enter their indicator readings into the iPad so that we have a permanent record for every machine.
Over the past year or so, we've transitioned to cycloidal drives for all the rotary axes on the UMC. Now these have a lot of benefits, including greater speed and accuracy and better durability in the event of a crash.
For the final step, the guys stack the castings into what you can begin to recognize as a UMC. Since each of these castings was built up as an individual assembly, that keeps the geometry relatively simple. This is where we begin to set things like parallelism and perpendicularity.
After the machine has been stacked, it's brought over here to the final assembly area. Now at this point, the machine is customer specific with whatever spindle, tool changer, and other options like this programmable coolant unit that the customer's ordered. Next, the guys will start wiring the machine and performing various geometry checks. After that, the sheet metal's put on, like you can see here on this UMC 1500 SS Duo.
Before any of these machines leave this area, they're inspected using both a ball bar test and a laser rotation check. The Renishaw laser interferometer gives us accuracies to plus or minus one arc second, And it's one of the ways we ensure that every UMC is built to spec and arrives on your shop floor ready to make accurate parts.
And last but certainly not least, each UMC gets two different test cuts, which is what Jason is doing here on this UMC 750. First, a 5-axis test cut. Now, after this test is done, all of these pieces are measured to make sure that all the axes, linear and rotary, are positioning accurately. When that's done, we get an additional 2-axis test cut that checks for surface finish. Now the machine is ready to ship.